stores, hotel rooms and aircraft seats. He's just back from the Olympics, where he topped the bill at a song festival in Seoul. But this was the song that made it all possible. Engelbert Humperdinck. The name itself conjures up images of past grandeur. And it struck me as I approached his home that the man who'd adopted this name and with it laid claim to fame and fortune had chosen the right place to suit his image.
Oh, hello.
How are you doing?
How are you?
Very well, sir.
Good morning.
Thanks so much. Glad to catch you in England.
Well, welcome to our home.
This is a pretty lovely house, too. The hall, this is so big.
And bright.
And bright, and very light indeed. Adding to the size and the look of it is a splendid mirror.
Well, I was in New Orleans, and I found this magnificent-looking mirror over there. And it's late 17th century, and it's French. I didn't know whether it would fit in or not. I just took that chance.
I find it quite amazing that you didn't actually take the measurements for that, because it fits so perfectly.
I've just got a good eye, I suppose.
What about the picture over the fireplace?
Well, that was that's my youngest boy. That's Bradley, and that's my wife. I thought it looked fabulous to see her breastfeeding the baby, so I took a Polaroid picture of it, and I gave it to a lady who was a painter, and she painted that wonderful picture, and I think it's wonderful, don't you?
Does Pat mind it being there?
No, she doesn't. She loves it.
Now, what about this staircase, too? I mean, that's the sort of thing you could actually feel so good walking down that in a flowing gown, couldn't you?
Now, Judith, I'd look pretty silly in a flowing gown coming down that stairs. Well, when we first arrived in the house, that was white, covered in this thick paint, and my wife thought it was very sacrilegious. She had it stripped down into its natural form, and I like it much better. It's much more elegant, isn't it?
How did you choose the furniture for the dining room?
My home in L.A. is a Spanish-style home. And then when we finally bought a home back here, it rather suited the English country-style house much better, so we brought it back.
And cherubs are everywhere.
Mm-hmm. That's the Dresden pieces that we have in our home in Los Angeles, and they're right here, too. And they're everywhere, and I don't know what the reason for that is. Maybe we weren't meant to have kids around.
But you have four.
I've been blamed for it more, but we have four, yes.
Spanish eyes. Teardrops are falling from your Spanish eyes.
Angie's Hollywood home couldn't be more different. It's the ultimate in showbiz glamour, built for the late Jane Mansfield. He believes strongly in fate and had met the movie queen shortly before her tragic death.
I was looking for a home in L.A. when I finally went over, and a real estate lady from Las Vegas was looking for the property, and she said, I found one that I think you might like. It used to belong to the late Jane Mansfield. And I said, is it a reasonable buy? She said, I think it's not that reasonable, but it's a very nice house and needs a lot of attention. So I said, her name is B. I said, B, I'd like you to buy it. And I bought it sight unseen.
Pat, here you have no staff. Do you take pleasure in keeping the house as in cooking
yes.
and all that sort of thing?
I think it's because it's the contrast. I can't do anything in L.A., so I don't really feel it's home. It's fully staffed. I don't have to lift a finger. And this is not me. I love it here. I love gardening. But when Engelbert's away, that's a great relaxation for me. I try to have all spring stuff and late summer because we're away all the summer. I'm not here a lot of the time. I live in America, so I'm only allowed so many days.
Getting away from the hustle and bustle of Los Angeles and Sunset Boulevard, where we live, normally live, you know, I think this is very peaceful for us. Mm-hmm. And I can get away. I can go into the village and have a pint and nobody bothers us, you know. Mm-hmm. It's terrific. I like it here.
One of 10 children, Ange?
That's right.
So what was your home like as a child? I mean, this is vast.
I know, no, it wasn't anything like this. it wasn't anything like this. It was, what do you call it? Semi-detached.
Mm. Is this your den?
It's my office, my working territory. I do a lot of work. I was here in my office till about 2 o'clock in the morning last night, you know. And mainly because I can get the people 8 hours back, you know, in their offices at that particular time. I can keep quite busy. In the last 2 years in Europe, I've accumulated these discs, and I've been very fortunate for that to happen to me. That particular photograph I'm extremely proud of. That was my one and only Royal Variety performance that I've done, and I was very proud of that. And I had the opportunity of meeting the Queen Mother. She was delightful. And now the end is near, and so I face the final curtain.
Ench had finally achieved the success he dreamed of, the classic rags-to-riches story.
I'll stake my case.
In the early days of their marriage, he and Pat were very poor and living in a small, dingy flat.
I mean, it was wonderful at the time. We enjoyed it. It was our palace, and there were no carpets on the floors. The furniture had springs sticking out of it. The television had those legs that you buy from the store, you know, put it in there. And we had a coffee table that was made out the back of the headboard of an old bed.
You made that, didn't you?
I made it, yeah. I was very good at those dishes, yes. And things.
Pat, which is your favourite room in the house?
Oh, I'd have to say the kitchen, without a doubt. Not because I'm a great cook, I'm not. That's a necessity.
Oh, God.
We have the television, as you see, in the kitchen. I just like to relax in the evening here with my dogs. That table, actually, was our first dining table. I had been to America and come back, so that has place of honour there.
Yeah. Pretty good having your own pub by your back door, isn't it?
It's wonderful, isn't it? I like it because, you see, I can invite the family in without... When you can have parties, you know, they don't have to go in there and make a mess of the house. This used to be like a tool shed, and a very talented person called Norman Jones, who did some of the paintings in the house, built this pub for me.
You're a pretty mean darts player, I guess.
Very mean dart player. And every time I play somebody, I play them for a pound, and it goes into the charity box. And, of course, at Christmas time, we give it away, you know.
You miss the old English pub, then?
Yes, I do, yeah. And I mention this every time I talk to people. As soon as I get off the plane at Heathrow, first thing, pint of beer, bag of crisps, and I'm happy. Although this house is not the kind of house that you cannot put your feet up with, you can. I like to live in a home. I don't like it to be a palace where you don't move that, don't touch this, don't do that, you know, and everything is spotless and really shiny. I don't like that. I like to walk into a home where I can relax and put my feet up on the chair if I want to, you know. It's mine.
Engelbert there, releasing another pint at his own local.